Had to set my phone to airplane mode because I don't, I'm not trying to get any interrupt calls while I'm recording this video. So, what is this video going to be about? Well, good morning to everybody, of course. Happy Thanksgiving to those who celebrate it. You don't really care for Thanksgiving too damn much. You know, these holidays just ain't the same once you realize certain things, but that's neither here nor there. I know some of y'all may be wondering, man, dude, this is like earlier than the time you would normally record videos or do any type of video upload. What's the reason for this? Like, how come you're at the house? Well, I'm recording this video because, you know, I have friends and colleagues, associates, and all these things that, you know, all these people asking me questions about, you know, what happened at my job, and they want the details of it. And this is basically me just killing all those birds with one stone. Everybody gets the information at once. So, let's get right down to it. So, of course, you know, I got fired from my job. And I'm going to go into the details as to how it happened, because the reason behind why I got fired, or the reasons, you know, it was two situations that caused me to get fired. That had happened that were completely out of my control. And it to this day, I mean, you know, I got fired yesterday, but it was one of those things that just, it happened, and I feel like as far as me being fired, more people are upset at the fact that I got fired than I am. Because this story actually has a happy ending, so, you know, it does have a to be continued, you know what I'm saying? Like, there is a part two to this, so, well, not to the video, but to this situation. And I'm going to explain all that later on, because I don't want people to be expecting another video later on of me doing any more explanations. Everything's going to be explained in this one video, but there's a happy ending to this situation. So I started my new job at the place that I'm going to refer to as the Blue Warehouse. You know, I've been around the internet for like, since 2006, that's when I really got into the internet and YouTube and all that. And I know there's people on here that are relentless that will try to figure out where somebody works, and they will call their job, harass them, and try to get them fired, because people are just evil these days. So I'm not going to disclose what the name of the place is. I'm going to just refer to it as the Blue Warehouse. For those of us who know what the Blue Warehouse is, that's what we're going to call it. So I got hired at the Blue Warehouse on October 16th. You know, I left my department slash retail job, the department store slash retail job, because I was getting tired of the retail scene. And I had friends that worked there that was moving on to this Blue Warehouse, and they, you know, they told me about it, and I went over there. I think I was like the third person from the department retail job that actually went over there. So it's like a migration. It's funny because so many people from that department store ended up going over to the Blue Warehouse, and I'm trying to clear this up, and they ended up, you know, getting hired over there. And I was like the third person. It was just like a good handful of us that left there, because I guess we was all tired of, you know, not being able to get tasks done. And in a sense, you felt like you were getting blamed. Well, not even, some of them actually were, but it's like, when you get assigned something at this department store, they expect it to get done in like a little bit of time, but it's customers first at this department store. So it's like, or at any retail job, basically, but at this one, it was customers first. They preach that, and they want people wanted the associates to follow that, you know, bar none, no excuses. Whenever the customer needed something, I don't care if you was working on a task and you was in a hurry to get that finished, you gotta help the customer out. You gotta stop what you're doing and help the customer out. That's what it was. And me, you know, I worked on the forklift over there, and I drove some of the other machines, And I just got tired of it because, like, if the supervisor, you know, or the assistant managers, they gave you like a specific task to do, the task shouldn't take any longer. I would say than like 30 minutes to an hour. You know what I mean? But because of so many of the customer interruptions, oh, somebody needs something pulled down from the top rack, or somebody needs you to get something down with a forklift outside in the garden area, or they need to go check the back cage to go do this to make sure the customer's order is right. You know what I mean? It's just like little things, that constant little nags that pulled you away from the one thing that you were supposed to be doing, that the you know, that the higher ups wanted you to get done for whatever reason. And you know, I couldn't get them done. You know, those customers would turn, I was getting interrupted by customers so much that the customers would actually turn a 30 minute to like an hour job into like a 2 hour job. And mind you, I was working there part time, so some days I was only working there 4 hours. So if the task was only supposed to take me like 30 minutes and I was supposed to move on to like the other one, the customers would interrupt me so much that it would extend the time, you know, exponentially. So I couldn't really, you know, get shit done the way I wanted to get it done. So I got tired of the retail scene. I was looking for something else. So when they told me about the Blue Warehouse, I went over there and I was like, man, you know, I was happy to be over there when I got hired. I tried to hold both jobs for a while. So I tried to leave as like a 2 week notice. You know, fly by in my video. And I just got tired of, you know, not being able to get anything done. So when I got put over here at the Blue Warehouse, I was happy because I was getting tasks done and things like that. Now, I got hired at the Blue Warehouse at on October 16th. You know, and of course, like the first, and they put me in the wrong department, which is funny. They put me in a place called finishing. And finishing, you know, that's where they, you know, put like the wood stains on like the doors and things like that. And then you have to like sand it down, because I don't know how they get the doors before they stain it, but they really need to arrange that area to where like they sand the doors down, then they stain them. That way you're not risking taking the stain off the doors. You know what I mean? It's like one of those things. So I don't know, but that's just my opinion about that place. But they put me in the wrong department. They told me they was gonna put me in a place called FA. I'm not giving away what it is. Like I said, people are thorough with their research. They could probably find out. Me saying finishing probably already gave it away. But yeah, I was supposed to be in a place called FA. And FA, basically what that is that me putting the hardware on the doors and, you know, and such before it gets moved on to actually be built. So that was the department I was supposed to be in. And they told me about that, you know, when I first went into orientation, they were going to put me over there. You know, because they give you a walk around the warehouse prior to them actually hiring you to come in and work. And they told me this is where I was going to be working. So when I first got hired, you know, like officially, which was on the 16th, they told me to go to finishing. So I'm like, okay, I didn't question it because I was just happy to just be put on. So I was like, okay, so what am I doing over here? So I learned, you know, the whole sanding thing. I was doing that, and then like 10 minutes into me doing that, I was getting used to it, even though I hated the smell in there. Like, they give you masks and things like that to protect yourself from like the chemicals and all that. It's like, but you can still get whiffs of it. It's just like it stinks. So over there, but and yeah, some people over there that just work without masks. I don't even know how the hell they do it. Maybe they just got so goddamn used to the smell that it just don't bother them. But yeah, I couldn't work over there like without a mask. But I was getting used to it. I was enjoying it. I was like, okay, this is fine. You know, this ain't bad. Like, I can get used to this. And 10 minutes into me doing that, you know, one of the human resources, you know, well, I don't want to give her name out. I'm gonna just call her DR. She came and she pulled me away from there. I'm like, oh, you're in the wrong department. I'm like, what? I'm like, I thought I was. You know, they told me I thought I was supposed to be somewhere else, and they put me over here. So I was like, I didn't question it, but Was like, no, you're supposed to be over in FA. So I was like, okay, fine. I went over to FA, and of course, I learned this is what you got to do. You got to put the hardware on the doors before it gets sent off to build, to be built. Basically, any final prep that needs to be done prior to it being built, that's what you have to do in that area I was in. Now, for the first couple of weeks, I was good. And this is like before my first paycheck from there. And I started on a new pay period, so I got a full 2 week check the first time I got paid, though. But when I, first started over there, of course, I'm new to it, so I'm working slow. I'm trying to be somewhat at a higher than expected fast pace, but they know that because I'm new. I'm trying to make sure not to make a mistake and do anything that I gotta respect their due privacy over there. I don't wanna have them walk outside and get seen. But yeah, dog barking. But yeah, I don't wanna, slow everybody down just because I'm the new guy. That's my mentality going into any job. I think everybody should have that. Check the slippers. But yeah, I was, moving at a consistent pace. I was relatively slow compared to how I am now or how I was. I would say like my second week there, or rather my third day, because that's when I really started to pick up the speed. And yeah, it was one of those situations where you got to start off slow to learn everything, and as you learn what is what, then you start picking up the pace and you start picking up the speed. On my third day there, I was working at the speed that I would say I wanted to work. Of course, I still had to learn how to read, like the blueprints, and things like that. And I was still making mistakes even up until like the week before this week, because there was some stuff that I just didn't, see before. But yeah, it was fine. Now, the way the Blue Warehouse works, it's just, so now that you got the understanding as to what, we do, this is a corporate job. This is corporate. This isn't a franchise. This is a corporate job. So they operate differently. Now, like most jobs in California, I don't know, because I know back home in Louisiana and in other parts of the South, some jobs have what's called like a strike policy. Basically like a baseball analogy. You know what I'm saying? Somebody passed by. I thought I knew who that was. But anyway, but it's basically like a baseball analogy. You know what I'm saying? When you get that third strike, you're out. Not such the case here in California, as far as at the jobs that I work. All the jobs run on what's called, but pretty much like all the jobs, like they run on a point system. And the point system basically works that when you first get hired there, well, here at the Blue Warehouse, it's different from other places, so I'm gonna just focus on the Blue Warehouse. I don't want to get too sidetracked. At the Blue Warehouse, during your first 3 months there, like you're basically on like a probation. You're basically on like a probation status. Excuse me, where you have to basically prove that you can show up to work on your first 90 days. You can't have, I want to say more than one absence, like regardless, so like even if you call it in and things like that. Now, I know this now, but because I'm the person, like, I hate calling out for work and I don't like being absent from work, I didn't think nothing of it. I'm like, okay, I'm not going to be calling out from work. I'm good, and I wasn't. And this is where like the random shit happens, which caused me to get fired. So I will say after my first check, I got there. After my first check, I'm working there, everything's cool, first paycheck, okay, I got it. So of course I gave them my direct deposit information early, so that I ho hoping that my direct deposit would kick in before my first paycheck. But they're like, no, your first check is going to end up being a paper check, so you gotta wait till your next one. I'm like, fine. So, and I ended up, because now mind you, at this time, like I had me one of those like one of those weird banks that's like an online bank, they don't actually have an actual place where you can walk into. It was like one of those weird, it was like an internet bank. And you know, I had no place to go, you know, deposit the check, so I had to go to like a check cashing place to try to see if I can get it loaded onto the card. Couldn't, so I ended up having to open up a new bank account somewhere. Ended up getting new bank account. Got the money put in the account, and they handed me a temp card. Now, for those of us who have been to banks before, you know, because I know with some people that are probably watching this, they don't even understand how banks work. You know, when you first open up account, they give you what's called a temporary card or a temp card. And basically, that card is going to act as your bank card until your permanent card comes later on, which should take about like a week or so, a week and a half, a week or two. And you know, that's the one that's going to have your name on it, the one that's coming to you. Like the permanent card is going to have your name on it, and you know, things like that, or any other type of customizations that you may have wanted on it, they'll do for you. You know, I got my temp card, and you know, everything's fine. So I ended up going to Walmart that fall, because this happened on a Friday, and I can't remember when the first. Like, I wish I would have brought that pay schedule from my room down here. But yeah, after that first check, I went and opened up a new bank account. I went to Walmart, which was right across the street from where the bank is. And you know, the Walmart, they have like this, like I want to say, like it's almost like a little deli section where they have like fried chicken and macaroni and cheese and like mashed potatoes, you know, things like that. I went over there to get me something to eat, because by this time, man, I was hungry. I was like, man, I'm off work, I'm paid, I'm feeling good, I got the weekend off, I'm hungry as hell. Let me just go grab something real quick and head to the house. So I go in there, and you know, I tell them, you know, let me get some macaroni and cheese, you know, let me get some chicken tenders. And then I seen like an item there. Now, mind you, at this Walmart over here that I'm talking about, they didn't have at the time, they didn't have like the items properly named. So I seen something that kind of looked like chicken nuggets, and I asked him what it was, and I swear he told me, the guy told me what it was, and I don't know if he just said it so quick that I didn't pay attention, or if I was just so hungry that it went in one ear and out the other. I was like, you know, he told me, he said it. And then I was like, yeah, look, I'll take like half a pound of that. And it was only like five pieces. But yeah, I got that, and I got to the house. I started eating it, and that's when I realized this is like waffle chicken bites. And basically what they do is that they grind up the chicken, they form it into a ball, and then they dip it in like a waffle batter. Kind of like sweet a little, and it is a little sweet. It's like a waffle batter. Basically, it's Walmart's version of trying to do some chicken and waffles, some deep fried chicken and waffles, basically. And it was okay. It could have used some syrup. Basically, that's basically what they were going for, you know, chicken and waffles, you know. But the batter was kind of sweet, and it kind of went well. Like I was fucking with it a little bit. But then again, when you're hungry, like hungry is the best seasoning, so anything damn near tastes good to you when you're hungry. So after I you know, got the food finished off, after I ate everything, you know, about like an hour or two later, I kind of start feeling a little, you know, woozy. So, you know, I just, you know, decided to lay down. Mind you, I work from 7 in the morning to 4:30 in the afternoon, so I don't make it home on this particular day until like possibly like near 6 o'clock. So I got to get to bed at around like 8 or like 11. And I'm just like 8 to 10, really, because the job, the Blue Warehouse, is like, it's a little ways from where I stay. So I have to wake up at like 5:20 in the morning. I have to call Lyft. For those of you who don't know what Lyft is, it's basically like Uber. Basically, that's like an alternative taxi service where people actually get hired to use their own cars to like basically act like a taxi. Much cheaper, much more affordable than taxis, because they got ridiculous with these taxi prices. Like they start. I tried to call a taxi a while back, and they told me that they were going to charge me for the time it takes for the taxi cab to get to your house as well as take you to your destination. I was like, fuck that shit. But yeah, it was like ridiculous. I never tried to get a taxi after that day, and I started using Lyft or Uber exclusively. So, but yeah, I started feeling woozy, and then I ended up going to sleep. And in the middle of me, sleeping, I'm just, I wake up because my stomach is just like it's fucked up. So I'm going to the bathroom, of course, going to the toilet. So we all know what that means. yeah, like I had the BGs, I had the bubble guts, like that, whatever that waffle chicken bite shit. I never went back to Walmart and got that. I never went and got that ever again. I like Walmart. They got some cool stuff. She almost hit that car. At the deli, but I never went back and got that. I never went back and got that. Screw that. I'll never do that ever again. But yeah, on that particular day, me trying something new, it came back to bite me in my ass. Cause I was, man, I'm talking about getting up in the middle of the night, just going to the bathroom every 5 to 10 minutes bad. Like it was, yeah, like it was rough. So finally, when I think the danger is over, I go to sleep. I'm like, man, I'm gonna wake up and just go to work, and all this shit, all this nonsense is gonna be over. I'm trying to refrain from saying curse words because YouTube has that anagram program, or that the fucking the damn it habits. But they got this program that's like a voice, whatever, and they'll limit the ads or like give you that fucking damn it that they put that status on one of your videos, and then your video got to get reviewed before they approve the ads to be put on there. So you got to refrain from cursing or whatever on your videos, because if they run it through that system and they pick up on certain words, then it's going to get hit with that, and then you got to wait for the review for you to put ads on there. But nevertheless, it's crazy how far technology is coming. I'm in the 90s, baby. But yeah, there's that. And I'm just sick, and I wake up the next morning, I'm feeling like basically a tad bit worse than what I was feeling that time when I was going to the bathroom in the middle of the night. So I'm just like, man, I hate calling out, 'cause me, I'm one of those people where you have to tell me to go home, basically. Unless I'm just down bad, sick, or anything like that, I'm not calling out from work. I don't care if my leg is hurting, And that was a situation that happened a little earlier from I think in between that, I won't say during my second check, but I'm gonna get into that later. But I didn't get in trouble for that. They sent me home because I was. But I don't want to get too ahead of myself. But basically, yeah, I had to call out of work. And what's funny is that they actually have a hotline where you call, well, not like a hotline, but it's like an absence line, basically. It's, you know what, it is a hotline, but that you call that when you're calling out of work. And you use the extension number 250. I can actually say that because y'all don't know the number to the place. You leave a message, and that lets them know, okay, this person is calling out. This is your supervisor. This is the department that you work for, and your reason for being absent. So I'm calling, I had to leave that message. I mean, man, I was bad, because I'm smart enough to know that if I do go to work like this, I'm gonna have to leave. They gonna end up sending me home anyway, because I'm gonna have to go to the bathroom like every 5 to 10 minutes. I was just feeling that bad. So that's basically what it was that day, and this happened on a Monday. So yeah, that happened. So that was like the first occurrence of me being absent. And mind you, like I'm already 2 points in. I don't think I explained the limit, but yeah, about me being on the on that first 90 days, like my limit of points that I could accumulate was only like at max, I want to say 5. But if you get like 4 within like your first 30 days, then you're done. And I swore, like, maybe it's because the months crossed over that I didn't really realize that it was still my first 30 days. That another random thing happened, and this is the one that really messed me up bad. To this day, I'm still confused as to how the hell this happened, but it was just like random, just like the food poisoning. I didn't even know what, you know, why I was feeling that bad. I didn't think that was gonna happen to me because of that, but you know. But yeah, I ended up going, back to work that following day. I was still feeling a little bad, but I was good enough to where I could move around and not, you know, and not have to go to the bathroom or whatever. So I was good. Then it was a situation where, you know, well, the way the department is actually like, basically the way that the Blue Warehouse is like set up, it's a big warehouse and you got different sections. My section, of course, was, you know, that was FA. But we build, you know, different things there, and but the jobs get stacked by Department M, I'm gonna call it. I'm not even trying to give away the department names. People are smart. They'll find it. But yeah, but Department M, I basically get the jobs from them. I put the hardware on it in my area, and then I pass it on to the next area where they actually build the jobs. So, yeah, I was, you know, moving in between the railings. And mind you, the railings were kind of like close. Now, gradually, they did open them up and widen that gap. But at that time, it was kind of like hard to maneuver between, like, I could get through, but it was still kind of like, you know, difficult. You had to have your feet like wide open and like a wingspan kind of, and you gotta like you kind of gotta like walk sideways, you know what I'm saying, like anybody from South Park. You had to just walk sideways kind of like that. You like, you're hopping to the side almost like you're trying to sea walk, but no. But yeah, I'm walking in between those railings, and then, you know, as I'm getting one of the jobs, for whatever reason, like, I just started feeling like this pain, this sharp shot up my leg, and I just couldn't explain it, and I didn't say anything. Again, this goes back to me saying, you know, I could be hurt, you would never know it, because I'm not saying nothing, you know what I'm saying, because I really don't like being out of work, I don't like leaving work, I don't like calling out, it's just a pet peeve of mine, you know, like, I'm just built like that, you know, and, you know, I don't like being late for work or anything like that. But, you know, on this particular day, like, my leg was hurting. I was limping a little bit, but it wasn't to where you could tell. Like, you know, like, they see me walking around all the time, and I got, like, a little swag when I walk, so it got a little limp to it. So they didn't think nothing was wrong for the people that did see me. And anybody, and if anybody did ask, I was like, no, ain't nothing wrong. I'm good. They basically, you know, eventually, you know, this is like 2 hours before I want to say like an hour or two, an hour and 30 before I actually had to leave work. You know, my leg was just like, it was just in too much pain. I'm leaning over the side, trying to like work my leg, trying to like shake it, get it back. They're like, come on, man, I only got an hour and 30. You can power through this. And I'm just like, it's not going to work, because I can't even put pressure on my leg at this point. So I ended up telling the supervisor that they told me to go tell the supervisor. Because, mind you, there's cameras all over this damn warehouse, so you can't hide anything even if you wanted to. but yeah, I ended up doing that. They sent me home early. You know, they asked me what happened. They put it down in the books. And, okay, he hurt his leg somehow. Basically, I had a knee tweak. Like, I had tweaked my knee. And I know I didn't hit my knee on anything, and I didn't get any, you know, like, points or anything for that. So I even asked them about it later on. They told me they didn't give me no points for that. So to this day, I don't even know how to explain that. I guess because I was moving in between the railings, maybe I had my foot twisted a certain way, and when I put my foot down, you know, it kind of tweaked my knee a little bit like that. That's the only thing I could think of, but other than that, I don't know what happened. But I didn't tweak my knee like that, so they sent me home that day. Now, this next situation, this is the one that was the straw that broke the camel's back, and this is the one that really messed me up bad. I mean, I'm talking about, I'm still confused as to how, mind you, all this is like random stuff, minus like the knee tweak, because that's not even counted into why I was fired. But But yeah, I ended up, okay, like I was talking about earlier, when you go to the bank, they give you like a temporary bank card. And I want to say this probably happened November 2nd, I want to say. Because I do have the text messages, or was it November 6th? I don't know. Like, I don't remember. But, I have the text messages that I'm recording right now. I don't want the video to stop. But it was either the 2nd or the 6th, but it was on a Friday when this happened. No, it was on a Saturday when this happened. So I was, mind you, it's already been like 3 weeks now since I got my temp card, and they told me it was going to take a week and a half for me to get my new card, a week and a half, 2 weeks. So I'm getting kind of curious now, because like it's been going on like 3 weeks now, and I didn't receive my card yet. So I'm calling the bank, and when you call the bank, you have to put your card number in, and then you got to put in like your PIN number, and then they'll let you talk to somebody about it. Now, as I'm talking to the lady, the phone gets disconnected, which happens, far too often at a lot of these places when you call them. Ended up calling back, and mind you, like some of these banks, they like the one I have. Some of these banks are like, they have these automated menus, and you gotta navigate through the menu just so that you can talk to somebody. And some of those things are like such a hassle that it drives you nuts. So I call back, I talk to the lady again, phone gets disconnected again. I'm like, come on, I just wanna know if you guys got a tracking number for my card or something like that. That's all I wanted to find out. So I call back again, and at this point I'm already familiar with the with the automated message. Okay, when it begins to say this, okay, I hit three, then I go do this, I put my card number in, and boom, I talk to somebody. So as I'm putting my card number in, right, I'm typing the card number in. Out of nowhere, and I literally, out of nowhere, I get two text messages telling me that my temp card got blocked. Now, mind you, this is the card that's on my Lyft account, so that's my only way to work. And I refrain from calling out because, like I said, I don't like calling out of work. But this happened on a Saturday, right? So I'm asking family members, yo, is there any way you can take me to work on Monday? All of them said, they couldn't do it. So, one, I understand because, they got their own jobs to work with. Two, a lot of us will go to work early, early in the morning. Some people leave the house at 2 o'clock in the morning. Other people leave at like three. You know what I mean? I'm the only person that leaves at around like, I would say 5:30 to 6 o'clock to go to where I am. So I'm like, I'm completely assed out at this point. And I was trying to figure out if there was any way I can come to the bank and get a new temp card. But I was like, well, you gotta pay for it. I was like, well, damn, I got money in the account and I couldn't, access the funds. So I was just like, I was completely assed out, and I was mad, dude. I was mad, mad, mad. Because this is like, dude, out of all, because I don't even know what the hell happened. I'm putting my number in. I know I didn't mishit any buttons or any numbers on the menu, and I get text messages telling me that my card got blocked, and I don't even know why. Like, I'm just so confused at this point, to this day. Mind you, my card got blocked like 2 weeks ago, and of course they had to put another card, on rush order, but that didn't show up until that Monday of that week, and I was just like, crap. But I figured, okay, well, if I call out, work, it'll be better than a no call, no show, and maybe I can control the amount of points that I accumulate. That way, I won't be fired. Now, they didn't say anything the first week. The second week after that, they didn't say anything. I'm like, okay, good. I must not be in that much trouble because then I'll be fired already. Because the thought of being fired didn't even cross my mind. Now, the manager of that area that I work, I'm gonna just call him RM. RM. You know who I'm talking about. He, like, it's already like 4:20, and at this time everybody's cleaning up. I just came from the bathroom, trying to restock, all the shelf, parts and things like that. I asked them, I don't even know why my phone stopped recording, but yeah, I asked them I said, I was still kind of shaking. I was like, man, so I guess there's no chance of me coming back, huh? And if reapplying, they said, well, you can come back after 6 months. Like, oh, word, I can come back after 6 months. So, of course, they take me throughout the warehouse. They get me get my jacket, turn in all my safety equipment, all my glasses, the gloves, threw them away. My ID, handed it in. It was just like, it was a surreal moment because, mind you, I've never been fired from a job before. You know, not even close. Maybe at my last job, or maybe it was because I had so many, maybe like the point limit was high over there, that at times where I thought I was going to get fired, they just never fired me. So, me, I'm the type of person where the reason why I don't like being out of, absent from work or whatever like that, because I don't like, I like to leave the job in good graces. You know what I mean? So that's always been my thing. And the fact that I wasn't able to leave in good graces that, well, I have to rephrase that. I think I left them I left them in good graces, even though they fired me. That's not the way I wanted to leave the job, basically. I wanted to leave, because I had another opportunity lined up or something like that. Like I said, I'm not in a financial bind or any type of financial woes or anything like that. It's literally just the fact that, I got fired. And it's the reason why I got fired. I'm not mad at them for firing me because I understand their position. That's their job. If I don't show up to work on time and I'm absent, then it is what it is. I have to get canned. That's their job. If they don't do their job, then they're going to get fired. Like, I get it. I'm not mad at them. So the thing that I'm mad at is this random ass bank card block. You know what I mean? That's the thing that bothers me right now. Like, I can't even, I'm still thinking about it. And I'm just trying to figure out, oh shit. And I'm just trying to figure out what the hell happened that caused that card to get blocked. Because that was the straw that broke the camel's back, and that's what caused me to get fired, because of that right there. And I'm just like, dude, I can't even think. My mind is still spinning behind the reason that happened, because I just don't know. At the very least, like, when something happens to me, I want to know why it happens. You know what I mean? I don't want it to be such a random occurrence that I'm lost in as to what the hell just happened here. Okay, I got fired. Okay, well, the reason I got fired, because, because I was absent, I accumulated 4 points within 30 days. That's unacceptable in their eyes. So they had to let me go, which is fine. Like I said, I'm not mad at them for doing their job. That's the policy. Okay, you're just doing what you're supposed to do. Me getting food poisoning. Okay, I didn't know it was going to happen, but at the very least, I know what caused it. This bank situation, this is the thing that I just can't put a finger on it. What the hell happened? And I can't. And it was the most random thing, and it just fucked me up. And I'm just like, I'm still kind of, it's like, I don't have an answer for that one. And that was the thing that caused me to get fired. And I'm just like, dude, like this, even back in Louisiana, because you got to understand, for those of you who've been subscribed to my channel for so long, you guys heard me make videos since before I even came to California. Back in Louisiana, I've spoken about this countless times. It seems like anytime something good happens to me, something bad happens to take away that something good. It's always been like this all my life. It's literally always seemed like it's this dark cloud that's been following me. It's like anytime something good happens, it's only a matter of time for something to take it away. Something negative happens to take that something good away. And I just can't. And I thought I was past that point in my life. Even after the whole bank situation, I'm like, okay, all the negative nonsense is done. I got my bank card. I got, I can access the money. I can make it back to work. Everything's good now. I'm good. So literally when they called me up to their office to fire me, I swear the thought of me getting fired didn't even cross my mind. So I wasn't even concerned about that even being a possibility. It's just a real, real random situation, man. Just the only thing I can really describe it as, and is that it's bad luck at the worst time. Literally. But, even as I was walking out the door, like literally, they give you like this complimentary water bottle to use in the warehouse, to get water. This is the only type of water bottle you can get at the job because they won't allow you to bring any other containers there. But well, except for like lunch or whatever. But as far as being in the warehouse working, you can only have this water bottle. And as I'm walking out the door, and me, like, I'm actually like a believer in omens. So as I'm walking out the door, I kid you not, I've had this water bottle since I worked there. Nothing broke on this thing at all. And I had the water bottle like around my finger, just like this, as you see, just like this. But as I'm opening up the door to walk out of the building, right? This thing, as I'm holding it like this, the fucking handle snaps. And as you can see right here, it's kind of like it snaps just like that. It just breaks as I'm holding it like this. And I don't, it's just an omen. Maybe it's just me and this job parting ways, symbolic of it. I don't know. It was just weird. But I'm the type of person, like, I have, instinctive positive thoughts. I always think about the positive over the negative. And here's the thing. Like I said, normally people in my situation, they'll be panicking. They'll be stressed out. I'm more stressed out over the bank situation than me being fired. Everybody else, friends that I've spoken to, they, they're more upset about this than I am. You know what I mean? Like, I'm not tripping on it because, like I said, my financial situation is straight. And they even told me, one, the positives, I didn't have any company violations. Like, I didn't fight anybody. I didn't come to work high. I didn't come to work, on any drugs. I didn't come on to work tipsy, as if I do that stuff anyway, because I don't. But, I didn't have any company violations. So that means I'm eligible for rehire, they told me. Like, you can come back, you can reapply for, to work here. Now, of course, that doesn't guarantee. Now, they told me that, but I'm like, dude, in the back of my mind, I'm thinking there's no guarantee that the position that I had would be open when I get back. So they probably end up putting me somewhere else if I do get hired there again. Hopefully not, but they probably do. But yeah, they said, I'm eligible for rehire, so that's a good thing. So just take it. And they said, in 6 months, you can come back and you can reapply. And I'm just like, cool. So my financial situation is straight now. I can actually last for 6 months as far as me being able to pay rent. As long as I don't go out and do like a bunch of excessive spending, I'm good for the 6 months, and even after that a little bit. So I can, I'm basically in a good position. I don't owe any debts or anything like that. I'm literally good. So I don't have any problems as far as that goes. But yeah, I have enough money to take care of the necessities for that 6 months that I'm going to be out. Unless I go find another job somewhere else, but I'm not going back to retail. Can't do that. I had a taste of the goody. I had a taste of the good stuff. I don't want to go back to the bad stuff, So that's not going to happen. I mean, if push comes to shove, I probably will go, but looking at it right now, I don't. I really. I'm not feeling the retail thing. I can't go back to that department job. But yeah, that. And they, told me that, hey, even the manager, even RM, he was talking to me. He said, hey, and just look at it as a chance for you to get everything together. And everything was sad is that everything was together. After that bank situation and I got my new car and I was like, okay, everything's fine. Nothing's, what I'm saying, out of whack. Everything's straightened out now. It's just that happened too late for me. You know what I mean? So And he told me a story about how, you know, he had never been fired from the job, and he got fired once, and that was, you know, the way he was describing it, it was like almost like he was trying to blame me for getting that, for getting fired. But I don't hate him for it. Like, I don't have no bones to pick with nobody at that job except for, you know, one person, white girl. Gotta stop saying nigga at work. You white, goddammit. Y'all know who I'm talking about. Mikey, Chris, talk to her. Tell her she gotta stop saying nigga. Like, you white, goddammit. It's black people that, like, I mean, I work with you, so I can't do nothing to you. You know, I ain't trying to get fired. Well, I wasn't trying to get fired for that. You know what I'm saying? I don't need that to happen. But yeah, she need to chill out with that. You know, you white, goddammit. Don't be saying that shit. But. Yeah, man, it sucks at the end of the day. You know, because like I said, it's the first time that it happened. I got somebody walking right there. I'm gonna keep the camera down. You gotta respect people's privacy. But yeah, man, that's it. It's just one of those things where it's like, it's just one of those things that's just crazy. And what's so incredible is that, no, like, one of the things that kind of threw me off is, like, you know, of course, when you get fired, like, they hand you, like, this letter of termination. They got your last check in there. They have, like, the unemployment benefits line that you can call. And they also give you, like, a letter explaining why they had to terminate you. Now, the lady that signed it, I'm not gonna say her name, I'm gonna just call her D Stone. We, you know, like, she doesn't really know, of course. Like, the letter that she gave me, that was basically like one of those, like, one of those letters that tells you, like, you know, saying, like, the best of luck in your future endeavors. And they give you, like, basically, you can tell that they copy and pasted that. And that's something that they give everybody that they terminate. Like, they don't personalize the letters for that specific for that specific person. Like, they'll put your name at the top of it, like, Dear Antoine or Dear, you know, whatever. And then they'll copy and paste, like, the rest of it. You know what I mean? So, because the reason why I'm saying that is because the reasons they had me listed as to why they felt they had to terminate me doesn't fit for the reason why I was actually terminated at all. It was like, in the letter it said, oh, you accumulated too many points. You were constantly told about your work performance. Like, first off, they never had to tell me about my work performance outside of the 2 weeks of my first 2 weeks there. You know, actually, my first 3 weeks. Let me say it like that. Because, you know, I'm still learning everything. So, of course, they're going to have to tell me. But that's not going to accumulate me any points, so I don't even know why you had to mention that. But, but yeah, it's like, you know, I knew it was like a copy and paste letter. It was just like, it kind of threw me off when I first read it. Like, at first glance, I was like, what? I didn't get it. You know, it was attendance. It was attendance. That was the only reason why I got, you know, fired, because of attendance. You know, it wasn't because my work performance was bad. I was actually one of the fastest workers in my area. Literally. Like, we would get done with the jobs, and we would be ahead of, like, we would be getting into the jobs for, like, the next day. 2 jobs in, already done. And so, you know, even at that yesterday, before I got, you know, fired, you know, we was done with everything. It'd be times where we have to go find other things to do, or they have to send me to other departments, you know, to learn, you know, how to do something else, or to send me to storage where they have to load the trucks or whatever. And they would have to send me to these other places because there would just be nothing for us to do. It'll be many times that they let us off, like, we were supposed to get off at 4:30. They'll let us leave an hour early because there's just, like, nothing else for us to do. We get done too fast, you know. So it couldn't have been my work performance at all. You can ask anybody that was there, you know, at, you know, like, that railing would be empty. It's nothing else for us to do. You know what I mean? You know, luckily, I'm a person that has, like, the skills to find things to do. So, like I said, the cameras are everywhere, so they're looking to see who's actually working. I don't like standing around anyway. So it all comes together at the end of the day. I don't like standing around doing nothing. I can find things to do, and you want me to work for my money. Okay, no problem. We all on the same page. You know, so yeah, man, that's it. That's everything in full detail. I know it's like an extra long video, but I just wanted to explain everything, and hopefully, you know, everything looks up. I'm gonna take this time to build, you know, the YouTube channel up, and get into other business ventures. Maybe go to a couple conventions, because that is within my budget. And just promote the channel. Maybe I can get something out of this. You know, I guess, you know, maybe the, because it just felt like the universe was against me. This is like the most random nonsense that could have happened to me at the worst possible time. And it was literally beyond my control. Like, I couldn't do, like, the food poison that I could take. Okay, I'm sick, I can't go to work. But this bank thing, this is the thing that I'm still kind of like shaky about that. Because it was like, dude, how did the card get blocked? I just don't understand how the hell the card get blocked. I know I didn't hit a wrong button, though. Like, why else? Like, I don't, like, I just don't fucking know. Like, I don't know. I'm still kind of hot behind that, because it's like, that was the reason that got me fired. That random occurrence, that was the reason why I got fired. I can't even come to terms with that, but it's like, it is what it is. Like I said, I'm not mad. I'm in a good position financially. And I didn't have any occurrences, so they told me I can come back in the next 6 months and reapply. So that's good. It's just that I wanted to leave the job. If I was going to leave, I was going to leave under better circumstances. You know, I didn't want to be fired. You know what I'm saying? So I'm eligible for rehire. Plus, I got unemployment. I don't know how unemployment works out here in California. So most definitely, I'm going to check that out. That's extra money I could be getting, of course. First time applying for that ever. Like, I'm just more shaky about the fact that I got, this is my first time being fired than actually being fired. Like, the bank situation is making me more upset than actually being fired from the job. That was the cause. I don't know, man. It's just random. But, yeah, man, that's it. That's everything. My body is still kind of going through, like, a shock. Because, like I said, I've been working there for, like a month's time. So, over the course of that time, my body has gotten so familiar with waking up at, like, 5:20, 5:30 in the morning, 6 o'clock, that I'm still doing that just naturally. Like, the alarm on my phone don't even be on when I, you know, wake up at that time. It's just, like, I'll be waking up before the alarm go off. So, my body is still going through that, you know, change. I don't know, maybe I'll go to the gym more often like I wanted to. I got that in the budget, lose some weight. That way when I get back there, I'll be moving around faster and I can handle things better than I was. It's just that, man, it's just one hell of a blow to me. And I'm just like, dude, more so my pride is shook, because I never wanted to be the guy that got fired from a job. And because of some random bullshit, that's what caused it. And I'm just like, man, can I catch a break, please? I don't know, man, but I look at the positive more than the negative. My money is good. I can survive for the next 6 months until I go back. Hopefully my job, the position that I would like to get is still open. If not, you know, I'll be happy with just working there, period. But it's one of those things that's just, you know, I ain't got no occurrences. I don't have no personal conflict with anybody there. It's just, you know, it's just one of those things where it's just, man, I guess the universe understood that I probably needed a break more than I realized. I'm just taking it as that. So, yeah, man, that's it. So, thank you guys for listening to this extra long video. I know it was long, but I went into detail with everything. Hopefully that answers all your questions as to what happened. I'm going to get back to doing what I was doing prior to that. I'm not going to the department store, but trying to build up this YouTube channel. Maybe find some tournaments, win some prize money, you know, things like that. I just got to find out when these tournaments are. That way I can finally win my team jersey, you know, World Warriors Collective. That story is open, so check it. Check the link on my YouTube channel. Yeah, man, that's it. So, thank you guys for watching. Peace, and we'll see how things go.